Hey everybody, welcome to Echoes of Color with Jeffrey Morrison.
Today
We're going to do another whip and chat while working on Diamond Art Clubs on Golden Shores by Chuck Pinson. Alright, there we go. Square, 29.1 by 21.6 inches, 74 centimeters by 55 centimeters, 48 colors and 3 ABs. 136, 129, 141. All right. So, hopefully everybody's had a good week so far. It's been pretty low-key. Worked a couple days. Yep. Did a color and chat yesterday, and whip and chat yesterday as well.
However, my whip and chat didn't export until today, earlier this morning. So,
yeah.
So, if you see two whip and chats for today, I just did one of them yesterday. So,
all right. Oh, excuse me. 400K. All right. So, basically, I'm just like working up to here. Just kind of making a boundary.
Kind of basically the bottom of the roof here. This house, so I'm not
diamond painting everywhere. It's a nice sunny day. A few clouds in the sky. A nice fresh crop of dandelions. Yeah, traffic's been pretty steady on the highway. No Canada geese at the pond, but there's been a robin that's been flying into the front window of the studio here. So yeah, that's basically a quick update, really. Yeah, it's been a pretty low-key day. So far, just finally got the chance to sit down and do some diamond painting. Yep. All good. Hopefully do some more coloring, because the coloring page I have now is pretty busy. Yeah. A lot of the page of the color. Just basically started with black to start, and it's kind of scattered everywhere in the picture. But yeah, just do one color at a time, and we'll have that page colored in no time. As for this canvas, yeah, I'll work away at it as usual. And get it filled eventually. Yeah, just these kind of things take time. Doing some window. Areas of window here. This looks like a balcony of some sort. Yeah, could very well be three windows. This building here. Not sure exactly 100%. Looks like that roof from this house kind of finishes off here. Yeah, it's different. Okay. Alright. A line of K's in this third window here. There's a K right there too. There we go. Alright. Oh. Yeah, I was going top down, yeah. That's why there's a chunk of numbers. Alright, so last night I watched a fellow YouTube creator showcase some new Sharpie markers, fine tips and ultra fine tips. So I'll have to see if there are Sharpies available that are ultra fine tips, I guess, so I can color more intricate spaces in some of my coloring books and future coloring books for my coloring chats. Yeah. I kind of do like the Sharpie brand. I use Sharpies a lot for word searches and stuff, so yeah. There's like 20 colors, so there's a good chance that I won't have too much trouble finding colors I need to color some pictures in some books in the future. But yeah, eventually. Need a really good selection of markers, really good color selection. So there are different shades of brown and blue and all that. Most pictures now. So, especially the adult coloring books, which basically have a couple of. Yeah. Just to kind of get the effect of shadowing and all that. Okay, I'll put you here. Alright. So, a window frame there. Put the tweezers down there. There we go. Keep them handy. Yeah, my mom has a pretty good stash of coloring books, but a lot of them are not color by number, which I'm kind of aiming for to do on the channel, but yeah. I found another one, but just gonna finish my current coloring page and then I'll flip through the one that I found in my mom's stash. She doesn't color heavily, but the books are still around. And if I do have trouble finding a color, she has a good chunk of Sharpie pen markers hanging out that I could probably use if my scope of color doesn't meet the needs of any other coloring books. So, I basically try to find the colors that I need and then just, yeah, record. With everything kind of pre-set up, it's just a lot easier. Some sort of a really, yeah, doors were up here, windows, and then probably a patio door, something. Yeah, it'll make more sense once I fill it in, I'm sure. almost fell off of the pen there. Down here. Oh, there we go. Got the mail. Aw, oh, man. Your drill's flipped over on this tray. I can go over here. Two more drills, stick together, and some drills that are refusing to step. Here, flip over. Okay, there we go. More 400 on here. Just needed two more drills and a full tray here. Great. Oh, pour them back in. No worries there. Okay. Here we are. Okay, let's step around. Set that pen down there. Little ledge. Not breaking that new pen that I just got. Yeah. On my to-do list. Alright. It's the only acrylic pen I have, so. Only fancy pen I have. It was a gift, so. Let's not drop it. Okay. 301, I believe. Three dots and a triangle. Yep. Let's get a good amount. Oh, itchy. Okay. All right. I'm sure every canvas makes more sense once you fill sections in. Yeah, to me sometimes it just feels like part of the canvas seems off. Just doesn't seem right. Putting the drills down, but after it's usually filled in, it just looks better. No, probably happens to the best of us. Drills into a better position. Placing these ones. drill wants to keep sliding back up. There we go. Alright. Alright, let's do this edge again. Let's place the drills that I need to over here. So that I only fill in. There we go. Where I need to be. I literally forgot a batch of K's. Okay, what was K again? 400. Oh man. Literally looking at like K's right here. Oh man. That's going out of the container. Ridiculous. Oh my gosh. It's having one of those days. I thought it was just the upper windows of the house. Oh, it's in this boat too. It's color of drill. It's brown. Oh, lovely. Looking at your canvas, like, how much of the time? And then just, like, totally blank out on a section. Oh my gosh, all I can do is just laugh. Like, what can you do? There. Oh my gosh. Alright, here we are. Okay. 301. Three dots. Oh my. Oh, lovely. Would have had to go back and do the drills anyway. When you see symbols on a canvas, you see symbols on a canvas. It's apparent that, yeah, there's a drill missing when you're doing this. If you see a symbol, you know, you still have to place a drill over it. And it looks pretty goofy when there's no drill over a symbol, when the rest of it is covered. Oh man. Great time with these drills. Drop a couple. Chair on the floor. I'm not sure entirely. Oh, well, okay. It's having a great time today. All right, dropping a few drills at a time. As long as it isn't the tray, so that'll just be fun filled. This symbol is just kind of okay, here we go. going on the windows here. Before I toss this whole tray of drills on the floor. Oh man. Wonderful. Now we're getting better volume of the symbol instead of it being scattered everywhere. Symbols scattered around can be harder to find in a section. So when you kind of have a color block to do, it makes it a little easier. Row or column or something, a lot easier. Okie there. Oh, kernel load. Goes on all or two. Really? Oh. There. Ah. Man, that hit the floor. Lose these drills, man. They seem to want to go everywhere today. Ah, oh, there we go. I had a couple colors anyway. all these down here. Oh. Oh, excuse me. Oh. Oh, it's just one of those days. All right, what shade of brown do we have now? Ah, well, they're sticking to the tree. Single dot. That'd be 814 right here. It's like a purple. Yep, really dark purple. All right. Excuse me. Okay. Lunch attacks. Oh, yeah, got a little more done today on this canvas, so that's good. Yeah, let's do a bit at a time, all I can really do.
So you've been watching Echoes of Color with Jefferey Morrison. I will put my Facebook profile name down below in the description. The URL for my Facebook business page just kind of post progress photos of current canvas and coloring pages. And my Instagram, I do the same thing. Just kind of two ways to kind of update what's going on off the channel, etc. So, take care of yourselves, have an excellent day, and see you next time. Bye.